Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, every Thursday after Pentecost Sunday, we celebrate the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal High Priest. In this Mass, we lift up our prayers for us priests, that we may be faithful in our mission of being stewards of the Lord's mysteries and of being pastors of this church. We pray as well for one another, that we may live out our priestly function from the grace of our baptism, that we may also express it in our service and in our gentle acts of kindness towards others. As we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings, and let us ask the good Lord for His pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call the sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who for the glory of your majesty and the salvation of the human race made your only begotten Son the eternal High Priest, grant that through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, those whom he has chosen as ministers and stewards of his mysteries may be found faithful in carrying out the ministry they have received. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Our reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Every priest stands daily at his service, offering repeatedly the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God, then to wait until his enemies should be made a stool for his feet. For by a single offering, he has perfected for all time those who are sanctified. And the Holy Spirit also bears witness to us. For after saying, "This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws on their hearts and write them on their minds." Then he adds, "I will remember their sins and their misdeeds no more." Where there is forgiveness of this, there is no longer any offering for sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
You are the priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
The Lord's revelation to my Lord. Sit at my right hand until I make your foes your footstool.
You are the priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
The Lord will send from Zion your scepter of power. Rule in the midst of your foes.
You are the priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
With you is princely rule on the day of your power. In holy splendor, from the womb before the dawn, I have begotten you.
You are the priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. Please all stand.
Since he was son, he learned obedience through those things which he suffered, and having been made perfect, he has become for all who obey him the author of eternal salvation.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We might find today's feast as drowning and maybe so high and unreachable. Jesus as the eternal high priest. Walang hanggan na, kataas-taasan pa. And sometimes we use these words, my dear brothers and sisters, for royalty, for high-ranking officials, for dignity, and shall we say, for esteemed titles and kinds of living. But did Jesus really live an eternal and high priest or priesthood in his life? Well, we shall all answer a big yes. Pero hindi po sa iniisip natin na malayo, mataas, o hindi maabot na pagkapari o pagkatao. But his being eternal high priest led him to be nearer to us, be one with us, and at least be someone for all of us. And our readings today would supply to this consolation. Yes, he is eternal high priest, but he willed to offer himself for us. He sits, as we have heard from the letter to the Hebrews, near his Father para po gumawa ng tulay mula sa atin patungo sa Diyos. He is eternal high priest, but would always offer his self, his body and blood, in the form of bread and wine when we celebrate the Holy Mass. Hindi siya yung kataas-taasan at walang hanggan na parang walang kinikilala at wala nang iniisip na kapakanan para sa iba. Even though his life may be seen as noble and royal, he came to us and he always would live among us. Alam niyo po, isa din ito sa mga magagandang matutunan natin kay Jesus. He is eternal high priest, but never forgets being Emmanuel, being God with us. He might be royal and noble again and again, but he wishes to take care of us. Madami po kasi tayong inilalagay o mga taong nasa eternal and high positions, mga nasa kataas-taasan at walang hanggang mga kalagayan sa buhay, pero ayaw bumaba at makinig. Ayaw makiisa sa atin, kahit man lang suporta, ayaw ibigay. But Jesus as eternal priest may sound royal and noble, na pwede na niya pong kalimutan ang kanyang puso para sa tao. Pero doon mas lumawak at mas naging totoo yung kanyang pagmamahal at pag-aalay ng kanyang sarili sa atin. His heart grew large, leading us to God, serving us, blessing us, protecting us even until now, supplying us with heavenly graces up until now. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus is eternal high priest. Mataas at marahil makalangit na mga pangalan, but he remains to live inside our lives and in our history. He is always among us whenever he is always among us and would make himself present when we come to church and pray, when we get along with each other, when we see someone serving and caring for us. Jesus, the eternal high priest, is present always. That is his being high priest. Not far from us, but close to us. Hindi iba sa atin at kasama natin palagi.
Please stand.
Let us pray the Oratio Imperata ad Petendam Pluviam. Together, God, our loving Father,
creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood.
Send us rain to replenish our depleting
water resources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs.
At your command, the wind and the seas obey.
Raise your hand, Almighty God,
to avert the continuing rise in temperatures,
so that your people can engage in productive undertakings, and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother.
Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Lord, may our Mediator Jesus Christ render these gifts acceptable to you, and may He present us as sacrifices pleasing to you in union with Him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint John Mary Vianney, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Gathering all our prayers and praises into one, let us call on God, our Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before I impart the blessing, we would like to welcome all of you and thank you for being with us in our Eucharistic celebration. And we are joined in a very special way with our visitors, our sisters, the Sisters of the Divine Mercy from Quezon City. Maligayang pagdating po sa Manila Cathedral at maraming salamat po sa pakikiisa po sa pagdiriwang ng Misa. Palakpakan po natin sila, sisters. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, Ina.